are live at Pennsylvania, the Philadelphia Comic-Con at the Pennsylvania Convention Center. This is pro wrestling's golden boy, Stephon Theodore Benson, and we are in full force, waiting to catch a glimpse of WWE superstar Paige, who is in attendance tonight, as well a few other celebrities and well-known people here at Pennsylvania Comic-Con. I have friends here. It's going to be really interesting to see exactly what transpires here at Comic-Con.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is the golden voice of professional wrestling, Stephon Theodore Benson, here for the first time ever live at Comic-Con. We are here with...
Chris, I'm Matt Dragonspin.
From?
Time.
And you are? Asking you a couple questions about your experiences here this weekend at Philadelphia Comic Con and your past experiences. So let's start with you. Your past experiences at Comic Con. What was your favorite Comic Con as of recent within the past few years? And who else have you gone to this past?
My first Comic Con was 2013 in New York City. I dressed up as a little character. It was absolutely fun, obviously. But the last several ones I've been going to pretty recently.
Exactly, what do you do for CBS? West Philly?
I do everything. I'm on the radio sometimes. Mostly I give away free t-shirts and, you know, pander the crowd a little bit.
No crowd. Okay. And how many times have you been here at Comic-Con? And what exactly does it see you?
Seth, he looks like a moron sitting there. Looks blind as a bat. I got video of you watching.
Pretty positive. How do you feel about them actually? the Velociraptors on the rescue, and I thought it to be a little unbelievable. It looks cool, but I'm not sure quite how it's going to play out with the audience.
Honestly, I don't know how it's going to play out, but the idea that dinosaurs are listening and behaving the way that they behave with each other makes it better than the last Jurassic Park.
Shoot, Jurassic Park 3 wasn't exactly the best. It was good, but it could have been a whole lot better. I think we all know that. Jurassic Park 1, obviously my favorite, and I'm sure yours as well.
Yes.
Jurassic Park 2 was still pretty decent. It's going to be interesting to see what kind of cameos we get in Jurassic World and what kind of dino fights we're going to get. We had the Jurassic Park 3, Tyrannosaurus Rex versus Rhinosaurus. We all know how that ended with the Spinosaurus standing tall. I personally think the T-Rex should have won. What do you think?
I don't know what to expect. They could have T-Rex that lands at the end, or they can all go against that big one. So, honestly, I'm just looking forward to it.
That'll be quite interesting to see if they actually team up against the new hybrid dinosaur, to say the least. Well, I'm here with the Dark Knight himself, Batman. Batman, how you doing today? Next year, we're going to see Batman versus Superman, Dawn of Justice, and I'm just wondering, what are your plans? You know, Superman seems to not be in the best of moods.
Yes, he's being blamed for the city that he destroyed, Metropolis, where he fought General Zod. But I am there to protect the city and also defend the honor of all human beings. He thinks he can go around and do whatever he wants. He is an outsider, but Batman always finds a way to take out his enemies.
Now, it being called Dawn of Justice, what exactly can we expect? What kind of justice are we going to see in that movie? Are we going to see some of the members of the Justice League in there, the other members?
Yes, we'll see Wonder Woman in this movie. Arthur Curry, the Aquaman, will appear. And also, Ray Fisher, Cyborg, will be in this movie as well.
Can we expect to see Shazam in this movie? He is one of the members of the Justice League.
Right now, I can't disclose all that information. But you never know. You just never know what could happen in DC Comics.
Well, Batman, since your last movie, The Dark Knight, what exactly have you been up to and leading up to the Dawn of Justice? What can we expect to see you between now and then? What can we expect to see you?
Batman will always be in Gotham protecting. He will defend this city as much as he can. It's not who I am underneath. That defines me.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard it first here at the 2015 Philadelphia Comic Con live at the Pennsylvania Convention Center. I'm the Golden Voice of Pro Wrestling, Stefan Theodore Benson. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Real Golden Voice. And where can the fans and all the followers find you and follow you?
You can find me on Instagram under The Real Dark Knight. Also on Facebook, The Real Dark Knight. All updates and information, any parties, bookings you need. I will be there to save the city.
You heard it first, The Dark Knight. Batman, ladies and gentlemen, pro wrestling's Golden Voice. It doesn't get any bigger, it doesn't get any better. It has been a pleasure. Thank you, Mr. Batman, Mr. Wayne. And have a great day here at Comic-Con. What do you have to say to the fans there on YouTube that are waiting to see The Dark Knight next year?
Stay tuned. It's going to be a good one.
X-Men who will appear in next year's blockbuster hit. It's going to be X-Men Apocalypse opening worldwide. And, fellas, I'm sorry, Mr. Wolverine, Mr. Cyclops, and Miss Jubilee, what can we expect from X-Men Apocalypse?
What I expect from X-Men Apocalypse? Going out in style. It'll be one of my last films. Figure I'll make a big impression. Maybe, no spoiler alert, you might see a little bit of the Horsemen of War.
Cyclops, you're bound to make a return in next year's X-Men Apocalypse. What can we expect from you? We haven't seen you in a couple years in the X-Men.
Step around, save the day.
He's going to save the day, and you're going to be the leader of the X-Men once again.
Of course.
Now, what can we expect? Because you see, Wolverine here seems to have been the leader for quite some time. What happened?
You know, I'm trying to steal my name, but I got something.
Speaking of that, X-Men 3. Exactly happened with you in the film. She apparently was not happy with you.
Yeah, we're not going to talk about that.
Well, that's a spoiler alert for next year's X-Men Apocalypse. Miss Jubilee, you're going to be one of the premier characters in X-Men Apocalypse. What do you plan to unleashing that movie, and do you plan to save the day more than your counterparts here?
I definitely do plan to save the day. I think I'm coming back strong for fireworks, and I'm ready to take on Apocalypse.
See, we're ready to take on Apocalypse, and do you all know the date of the
I believe it's May 2016.
May 2016 is going to be X-Men Apocalypse. It's going to be the biggest X-Men to date. The last X-Men was X-Men Days of Future Past. We saw this man here, Wolverine. We saw this man, Cyclops, make a return. Was not expecting that. Jubilee, where exactly were you in X-Men Apocalypse? What did you do?
I've been doing a lot of work and a lot of cameos in the X-Men movies, but I'm coming back strong, so.
What did you do?
Watch out.
You heard it first, ladies and gentlemen. For Comic-Con, this is Wolverine, Cyclops, Jubilee. Few members of the X-Men for X-Men Apocalypse next year in May 2016. I'm Pro Wrestling's Golden Boy, Stefan D.O. Benson. This is the 2015 Comic-Con. We'll see you next time. Thanks for joining us here on Golden Talk. With Jeremy Renner, Agent Bardenor, as he likes to be known, Josh. Josh, we saw you in the first Avengers. What can we expect to see in the Avengers Age of Ultron, and what do you have to hear at Comic-Con?
Well, you can see a lot of action and find out a little bit more history. I'm just here at Comic-Con hanging out, trying to make some kids' day.
So far, I'm sure you have. What exactly have you done so far at Comic-Con? Like, what particularly have you done?
Tonight for charity for children's pediatric cancer in Lehigh Valley.
Don't do it.
You don't want it. The pirate ship.
They're just going to shot at that ship right over there.
The group of pirates over there. The Black Pearl.
The Black Pearl indeed.
Because we always try to like.
All right, so now the Age of Ultron is released. It's one of the highest grossing movies of all time. And we expect to see a lot of the backstory of what exactly is going on with you and the Avengers. And moving on to the Marvel Phase 2, Infinity Wars 1 and 2. Can we expect to see you in the Infinity Wars at any point?
I think you might see a little bit.
And if you
want, wait and see.
Now, what was your reaction in the first Avengers when Loki caught your arrow?
I kind of figured he would, and which is why I left him a little surprised.
That was probably one of the best moments, especially with the smug look he had at the end. You got him good. And did you catch when Iron Man called you Legolas?
I actually missed that, but I caught it later.
Now, in the Avengers Age of Ultron, it's said that you do quite a lot of ass-kicking, if I do say so myself. And you did a great job in the first one. You know, unfortunately, Loki kind of got you there in the beginning with the little mind control. But this time around, can we see you kind of a little bit more conscious of mind control?
Yeah, I'm going to definitely do my best. Taking over mentally speaking, I guess you'd say.
Like you're done with the you know, the mind control thing for the most part?
Yeah, I'd really like to be. I'd like to keep my mind.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is the 2015 Philadelphia Comic-Con live at the Pennsylvania Convention Center. This man, his name is Josh, also known as Agent Barton, Jeremy Renner from the Avengers, and the Avengers Age of Ultron. Hopefully we'll see him in Phase 2 of Marvel's lineup of movies. Thank you so much, Mr. Renner, Mr. Josh, Mr. Barton. This is Comic-Con, our Pro Wrestling School Boys. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Stefan Theodore Benson, the golden voice of professional wrestling here at the Jurassic Park Oculus Rift experience, and it's absolutely awesome. The cameraman, Troy, my brother, he's enjoyed it himself. I've enjoyed it. What's going to be even most interesting is if we see Jurassic World June 12th, what's going to happen? What kind of dinosaurs and cameos are we going to see? All that and more, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Stefan Benson. This is Golden Talk, and that is Jurassic World. The park is open June 12th.
People are so petty and tiny.